गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द केमिस्ट्री क्लास। एंड टुडे आल्सो आई विल डिस्कस यूज ऑफ सम इम्पोर्टेंट मेटल्स। फर्स्ट विल डिस्कस द एल्यूमिनियम मेटल। ओके, एंड इट्स सिंबल इज ऑल ऑफ यू नो एल। ओके, now generally aluminium is found in the earth crust, and aluminium is the most abundant metal, okay, found in the earth crust. The best ore, generally aluminium is extracted, there is the bauxite, another is corundum. Okay, now the color of the aluminium metal is silvery white. Okay, and this aluminium metal is highly malleable, okay, and ductile. Aluminium is a very good conductor of heat and electricity, as it is cheaper than copper, so generally it is used for the electricity, okay, in different wires, generally whatever we are using in the street, okay, these are aluminium wires, okay, for conducting electricity. And aluminium utensils, so we are using in our home also, okay, and aluminium foil generally we are using for packaging of foods, okay, and there may be some aluminium foil, for food purpose you are using, okay, and aluminium powder paint, sometimes it is used to prevent dustings. And already I have told you that the bauxite is the cheap ore of aluminium, and this aluminium is a very soft metal, and to make it stronger we have to mix other metals, okay, to form alloy. And the most important alloy of aluminium is duralumin. Already I told you, okay, that aluminium is light metal, okay, soft metal, so to make it hard we have to mix copper, magnesium and manganese, okay. In duralumin the more than 90% is aluminium, and other copper, magnesium, manganese are there. And this duralumin alloy generally used for making aircrafts, okay, that means aircraft bodies, okay, and window panes. Sometimes window panes are also we are using, okay, that is made of this alloy duralumin, okay, and doors also made of aluminium, okay, and pressure cooker also, okay, this we are using this type of duralumin things, okay. Now scientists also prepared like other metals, that aluminium nanoparticle or aluminium oxide nanoparticle, okay. So these particles are used, okay, generally for drug delivery and for some material surface coating, and for some ingredient for rocket fuel in military explosives, okay, that aluminium nanoparticle or aluminium oxide nanoparticles, okay, that we can use, okay, like other metals also. Next metal we will discuss, that zinc. Zinc, its symbol is Zn. All of you know zinc is also a white metal, and generally metals are ductile and malleable, but this zinc is brittle, that you have to remember. And in laboratory hardened gasification you will use zinc anneals. Zinc anneals contain some copper impurity, okay, and these copper impurity will act as a catalyst, okay. And whenever you are adding some dilute acid, dilute sulfuric acid you are using in zinc metal, okay, then you will get hydrogen gas, okay. And in galvanization process also, in metal we have already discussed, you have to take molten zinc, and then there you have to dip that iron rod, and on the iron surface there will be coating of molten zinc, okay, and when it will become cool, okay, a very good coating will be there of zinc. And as in the metal activity series, zinc is placed above iron, so zinc will be oxidized, okay, and there will be no rusting on the iron surface, and this process is called galvanization of iron. Okay, so here we are using that zinc. Okay, zinc metal we are using. Next, zinc metal also we are using in dry cells like batteries. Okay, the common alloys of zinc we can tell about that the bronze and brass. Brass and bronze. Okay, so brass mainly copper is around 60% and zinc will be around 40%, and in bronze there is copper, zinc and tin also there. Copper will be around 80%, zinc 10%, tin 10%. Okay, and this brass we are using for making utensils, okay, electric switches, and bronze we can using for making medals, okay, making coins and statues. Okay, we are using bronze. And the oxides of this nanoparticle that means zinc oxide, they have huge amount of medical, biomedical applications like anti-cancer agent, it can be a antifungal agent, antibiotic, anti-diabetic agent. Okay, in tissue engineering we can use this zinc oxide nanoparticle, immunotherapy, drug delivery, okay, bioimaging, many different applications are there, okay, of this zinc oxide nanoparticles. Next we will discuss another important metal, that is mercury. Mercury, all of you know, it is coming from the name hydrargyrum, okay, and its symbol is Hg. okay, mercury is a metal but it is a liquid state. Okay, generally in room temperature we get mercury in the liquid state. It is also very shiny metal, okay, and silver color, okay, liquid metal. It does not moisten the glass, okay, and it expands and contracts even a little heating or cooling. Okay, so that is why this mercury, liquid mercury, we are using in the thermometer, okay, in barometer, okay. In thermometer we are using for in measuring the temperature, and in barometer we are using for measuring the pressure purpose. Okay, we are using mercury, so this is a very important use of mercury metals. Okay, and if you take any alloy of mercury, that means you are adding sodium and mercury, so this type of mercury alloy is called amalgam. Okay, when you are mixing that silver and mercury, okay, this is called silver amalgam. When you are making sodium and mercury, adding sodium and mercury, this is called sodium amalgam. Okay, so in this way different types of amalgam we are using, that gold and mercury, gold amalgam. Okay, these are used. And what is the use of this silver mercury and gold amalgam? Already we have discussed this. This we are using in the filling of the teeth cavity. Okay, that means in dentistry, that doctors are, dentists are using this alloy, okay, to fill up the tooth cavities. Understand what I am telling? And this mercury paper, okay, is or mercury is very much poisonous. Okay, all of you know about the Minamata disease. Okay, and the inhalation of this mercury paper can produce or can cause harmful effects to the nervous system, digestive system, immune systems. Even it can damage the your kidney and lungs. Okay, even huge amount of mercury consumption, okay, if it enters in your body, okay, there may be some blister and there may be some damage of this kidney and liver, and sometimes mercury poison can cause death also. And another very important use is there mercury. I forget to tell that in sometimes in the fluorescent lamp we are using mercury paper, okay, and that will give you a very good yellowish light. Okay, next, another important metal we will discuss, that is tin. Okay, Sn, this coming from this Latin word, the stibium. Okay, so from it we are writing this stannum. It is coming from the stannum. tin is coming from the sternum and its symbol is Sn. And tin is also a very good metal, okay, and generally it is not forming any rust. And tin is silvery white color. Tin is highly malleable but not ductile, okay. And we are using the different types of container of tin, okay, for preserving food, okay. And sometimes we are using the alloys of tin, okay, like time metal, bell metal, okay. And tin can be coated on the iron sheets, okay. And these iron sheets, that means iron sheets surface, there will be tin coating. And this thing can be used for making big containers like boxes, okay. Like this, okay. So in this way, today I have completed, okay, the discussion of four metal, and in my next class we'll discuss more metals. So today up to this, thank you.